the rose window. And a point of interest is that to notice all the major lines in that window are made of stone. And a personal story. My father spent 45 years as a stonemason, bricklayer in the West Michigan area. And throughout his total career, the thing he talked about the most and was most proud of was that he and another stonemason lay the stone that created this rose window. Dr. Bruins, that window has much to say, and we're simply asking you to please share the stories, the message that is displayed in the petals of that window.
Thank you. I'm very happy to do so, because it is if the chapel is the crown jewel of the campus, the rose window is the crown jewel of the chapel. Let's begin in the center with the explanation. The center depicts the seal of Hope College, which was adopted in 1866, the year the college was incorporated. Philip Phelps, the first president, must have been the designer of this seal. Interestingly enough, it was originally used English language for it. Somewhere in the process of time, the English was translated into Latin. So all the wording in that seal now today is Latin. But what we first see in the seal is the anchor. And this is interesting because goes back to the words of Viniralti himself when he wrote his first report following the first year of the Holland Academy in 1852. He said, "This is my anchor of hope for the future." So that, the anchor, became a vital part. And we also noted that the anchor is also used in symbols in the chapel windows along the side. Then this anchor, these words, the anchor of hope for the future, comes from the book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 19. But the word hope, as it is used, it comes from Psalm 42:1. And that scripture is mentioned in the seal also. And then that's why the motto of hope is "Hope thou in God," or "Spera in Deo." And so that comprises the seal of Hope College. Now, because Dr. Dimnitt placed the emphasis on that, I think he wanted to have seals of six other schools of learning, six universities that are depicted with their seals. The first one is the seal of the University of Leiden, a Dutch university founded in 1575, the year that the Dutch founded that in thanksgiving for overthrowing the Spaniards and getting them out of the country. But I think he picked that university because that's the school from which Viniralti graduated when in the early 1830s. Then he goes to the five university in this country. Now, I would have assumed, before I looked carefully at the window, that the first one would be Harvard, which is the oldest university in the country, founded in 1636. But it isn't. It's the seal of Rutgers University, founded in 1766. But he was partial to Rutgers because it was the first institution of learning founded by the Dutch Reformed Church in this country. So the second one, following Leiden, is Rutgers. But then he does it, the other four are in alphabetical or in chronological order, namely Harvard, 1636, Yale, 1701, Princeton, 1746, and the university, a secular state university, in 1817, although he used the number 1837, which is the year that the state of Michigan entered the United States and joined the Union. So that completes that circle. Then the next circle are panels of identical design. It's in the last circle, the large circle, and there we begin at the top, just to the right of the top, and go clockwise. The first one is the creation of the world. Then you go drop down a bit, you get to the Garden of Eden, and there are Adam and Eve enjoying the Garden of Eden. But the next one shows the effect of their act in the Garden of Eden when they disobeyed God. And here Adam is depicted hoeing in the garden or working the land as a result, as a payment for his sin, that now it was tough going for this first pair. Then the next one, however, we see the plan of redemption initiated by God with a picture of Moses, who received the call of God, led the Exodus out of Egypt and into the Promised Land. And that's followed, interestingly enough, by a picture of what is conceived to be the Ark of the Covenant. And this was this very sacred piece of our instrument in the tabernacle and then later in the temple, which symbolized the presence of God in the midst of his people. Then following that is the glory of the state of Israel, the country of Israel, people of Israel, with a picture of Solomon. Here Solomon sits on his throne with his robes and with the crown on his head. This is at the peak of the Old Testament in their prosperity and in their monarchy. It's downhill from here. And the next picture shows that. And here a person is sitting beneath a tree in Babylon, moaning the fact that the people of Israel now are in exile in this country and away from the promised land. But the picture of redemption is concluded in the top picture, just to the left of the opposite the creation of the world, is the birth of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. So that really completes this full picture that is seen here. The Seal of Hope College, the universities that Dimnit thought were significant in this country, surrounded by the story of redemption that concludes with the coming of Christ.
We are now going to talk about the sounds of the chapel, particularly the organs that make the chapel a complete experience.